How you doing, everybody? This is going to be an interesting video because we're going to butcher a pig and eventually roast it. I don't know how much I'll be able to get on camera. I'm going to be not videoing the pig being killed. I'll pause it, but I'll be cutting it out. I don't have editing stuff, so I have to pause and turn on and off. I'm hoping the phone right now is in the sun. Maybe if you move it back a little bit. There. Probably a little better on the heat on the phone, and might need to go get cleaner to clean my camera lens. So let me pause it while I go get that. Okay, hopefully that lens is cleaner now. And these are just my neighbors, and they're related to the owners here. And we were treading it recently when I got up to find two good-sized pigs running around the yard, and I'm thinking, oh shit, here we go. With smelly pig smell, and I didn't realize he had purchased them for a party, and of course they just keep them on the hook until it's time for the party. Well, the party I guess is tonight, and for his grandmother or mother-in-law, I'm not sure what, but I'm gonna get what I can get. Be patient. Yeah, I'm gonna be cutting the video on and off, pausing it because like I said, I don't have any way to edit it together. So that's my he's coming out now. We'll pause it for the kill. There's the piggy. He's like, I know what's up, bud. No, you're not eating me. And if they kill it over there, I won't be able to see it anyway. But shush. Dogs are going crazy. Pig knows what's up. Okay, we're gonna pause it here until, and we'll put it back on after the a little further. He's a little in the way, but it's fine. Pig is not happy. Did you do? Yeah, he's not happy, but we won't put the killing on video. Let me pause this and kill a butcher in the pig, so we're not having it, because YouTube will probably kill it or shut it down if it shows the killing of the pig. It's gonna give you a couple minutes of this here. Well, I guess when they get it tied up right, then they're killers, so I'm show you what they're basically doing, huh? Yeah, but it don't matter. I can't video the killing of it anyway. She wants to know if I'm blogging, so. Alright. Morgan.
Morgan?
Morgan.
Oh, okay.
You're...
I'm one of the daughters.
Alright, guys. Now they're scraping the hair. I'm going to let it run for a minute. The pig's already been killed.
Yeah.
let you see a little bit of that. They're scraping the hair off. I'm going to pause it again because I don't want the video to be too long. Oh, hey guys, they're stripping the hair off the pig now with this scraper. Like just a piece of aluminum. It's not even a proper scrap aluminum they're using to remove the hair. It's going to take a while for it to get to where they're actually butchering the pig. But the killing wasn't that big a deal. They just basically stabbed here and drained the blood. They had to get it under control to be able to do that. And the lady I was just talking to here, actually one of the family members who was related to my house, she lived in California and for like 15 years as a nurse, and just chatting about things here. You know, she likes it. She likes the weather there better in general, but she said right now it's too hot. She's been back for 3 weeks. But we're getting ready, maybe this. Most of the hair off, I think. Use the hot water, I guess, to get the hair to come off. Okay, let me pause it again, because it would be a very long video if you're just going to watch it spray hair. Alright, guys, hold on now. Okay, it's been at least about half an hour. They've been working on getting the hair off. They're down to like little razor blades now. And small scrapers getting the last little bits off, and they're working over here. I'm not sure if they're going to cook any of the pig in that. I think they're going to butcher on that table back there. One thing you'll find here in the Philippines, I've seen it a couple times, is a concrete thing like they got the pig on here, but at the other end there'll be a hole. It's kind of weird. It'll have a weird slope to it. It'll mean you'll see a concrete and it's sloped like this, and at the far end there's a hole, and underneath a hole. And what that's for is for the big round block to sit on. And the sloped concrete is for draining blood, leaving the pig up. A friend of mine just rented a house. Matter of fact, one of the house, for when I first saw it, I didn't know what it was, and I think in my video, I said, I don't know exactly what that's for. And that's, if you go back in my videos, there's one that said, do I want to live Pinoy primitive? And a friend of mine has rented that house, and I found out later what those things are for. And they're for butchering pigs. All right, let's continue to watch a little bit more here, and then I'll pause it again until they start to chop it up. Yeah, they didn't. Now they're using a torch, a butane torch, to, I guess, burn off the little bits of hair they can't get. Maybe dry the skin, I don't know. I would take more just to burn off the hair. And you'll find these torches available here. I've seen them for sale. They also have butane cookers you can get.
I want to see.
Sure, I can't pick you up to see. Somebody wants to see everything. Oh, shit. Okay, well, just a little bit of that so you can see that. I'm kind of breaking this down because I'm already into 10 minutes here and I haven't started the butcher, so we're going to pause again. Well, he's got the banana leaves. I don't know if they're going to do that to get the pig off of the hair that's underneath it. Maybe keep it cleaner. For the when they gutted everything, stays a little cleaner. That appears to be what they're doing. And always a process. The first I've been able to observe somebody actually doing this process. Also getting lots of hair that's on the horse. The dogs are going nuts.
Good.
Mike watches the pig. He gets burned. She wants to eat the pig. Yeah, it appears to be that's what they're doing with the banana leaves, to get the hair out from under the pig when they butcher it. And they get mixed back in. And we're going to pause again.
Oh.
No, not pause. Okay. I'm going to pause one more time, guys.
And then guys sharpening up his knife over there on the well, and the hand pump work. Yes, I know. He's going to drive me crazy. Determined to drive me nuts. But he's sharpening up his knife on a stone. That's his hand pump well. That's what they have next door here. You know, we have a well here and a water pump. And it's very related to the south. Yeah, I guess he's ready.
What? I don't think I want to have the gutting. And that's probably something that YouTube will frown on.
I see the knife.
Really? How do you think you cut up a pig? You need a knife. Don't be silly.
Can you just cut it with your finger, not the
knife? In the fingers. She wants to know if you can cut it with your fingers. Okay, here we go. Yeah, that's what they're using the leaves for, to get the hair, because it's probably sticking too much to the concrete, so they put the banana leaves down. I don't think anybody wants to eat hair. No, it's the tail.
What are they cutting it off?
Cutting the tail off. Okay, we're going to pause it here because we're going to be cutting up the gutting the pig. Alright, give me a moment and before he starts. Okay, they've gutted the pig now. And they're breaking the rib. They're going to be cooking it. Oh, the back. They're hitting it on the spine. It's going on a pipe. There's a pipe, I don't know if you can see, way over here on the side of the house leaning up. I don't know where they're going to actually cook it, whether it's going to be over here or on another spot in the house by the property. But there you go, guys. Basic process of preparing a pig for a party. Surprised. Oh, they're actually removing the spot. They're cutting it into separate pieces. Okay, so they're doing it a little differently. They're not cooking the pig as a whole pig.
Can I see your camera?
What? No, not right now, Trisha. It's up too high. Go inside and get the step. Go inside and get the step.
There's the step.
And bring the step over here and you can see. Yeah, I thought they were going to cook it as a whole pig, but maybe the two halves are going on the pipe.
It's here. Here.
That is here. Right here. There's nothing more to see than what we're already seeing.
Ooh.
Yeah, that's all there is. You can see it better without the camera.
Yeah, I can see.
Okay. Yeah. Let's zoom in a little bit. Preparing it now, I guess, to different pieces that they want to put on the... pointing at that part earlier. They were going to roast it. I thought he was roasting the whole pig, but... exactly sure how he set it up now. And they haven't got a pig set up. They may do it right here, maybe. You can see there he's got the very successful in cleaning out what they want. So they're
lucky today. Very few flies today. Recently there's been quite a bit. They kind of comes and goes with flies here. Some days it's just nuts.
Papa, I want broil.
Go have Mama get it for you. Mm-hmm. It's absolutely nuts.
6 years old, what do you want?
Oh, this is a lot of fun.
Wait, I'm gonna get home.
What are you doing? Careful.
Oh, maybe they're gonna roast. They have the same thing they had the pot on. You can put meat directly on. You can buy them here. People make them for you. Oh, they're bringing a big pot around. So I don't know how they're planning to cook it. They're gonna roast some of it and boil other parts, I don't know. And they have a second pig here they're planning on having for a different day. But thank goodness I found out this is not gonna be a regular thing having the pigs here because they're literally right outside our kitchen window. The pigs.
The pigs here. There's my kitchen window. So when I found out the pig was there the other day, I was like, oh my God. Oh my goodness.
Vintage battery cordless tools here, which actually made up with a brand that they sell here. If you look back in my videos, you'll see reference to that. But as it turns out, you can buy a really nice little electric fan and pop on the top of the battery. And yes, you can't get a big battery here. But this one, I shipped from the US. 9 amp battery. There's 9 on there somewhere. There we go. 9 amp rigid battery. And this is a nice little electric fan I got primarily for brownout purposes. And 3 speeds on off. And you can charge your phones off it. So I got it right here right now, just maintaining the battery on the phone. Wait, let's see what Trisha is doing here. Why are we doing that?
Because there's no oil in the lift. Don't you dare. Don't you dare, Finger. Next time, I will you tickle me.
Okay, back to the subject of the video. Oh, you cannot open it?
No.
Oh my, that is very tight.
Yeah. Some people do that and some people don't.
I'm splitting the coconut with a homemade splitter. Piece of steel welded on the end of a pipe. You're going to see a lot of that kind of improvised tools here. Cook primarily with coconut husks is very common. A lot of the charcoal you'll buy, it'll be burnt coconut husk. And it'll just be charred. You can't get apple woods and all that kind of stuff here for barbecuing. But I have devised a way to, you cannot get a gas grill here. Somewhere in the Philippines you can. On Lazada they show a gas grill, but is unavailable in this area on Negros. And the best thing you can get is basically what he's using there, or they have these tray, they put this stuff in, and there's not a lot of control of heat. It's about how much charcoal you use.
Papa, do you have a fire?
Everybody has a father, Trisha. That's a silly question. You cannot make a baby without a father and a mother. Don't bump. I'm talking to the video right now.
You're not a father. You're old.
Yeah. And how did Victor come about? When? Where'd he come from?
In mommy's tummy?
Yeah, but how'd he get there? How'd he get there? How did Victor get in mommy's tummy to come out?
Is he an egg?
Egg? No. Well, there's an egg involved, but no. He was not. Well, he was an egg. Yes. That's a bigger question. Oh my goodness. Put me on the spot here. Oh man. Welcome to the Philippines, guys. She has been nothing but 90 mile an hour questions for like the last 6 months. She's learning English so well. When I got here, she couldn't speak any, and she's picked it up incredibly fast. Stop making so much noise. I'm shooting a video.
What is the dread thing?
Oh my God. I don't know. Flower. What is that? Is the current question of the day. Yeah, I really thought they were gonna cook the whole pig, but they're not. And he's separating out all the, I guess, crap from the intestine. I don't know. I'm sure they probably use about every little piece of the pig they can. Why waste? You don't have to. And the kill was very much like what I've heard kosher kills are in the U.S. where the, you know, quick stab in the throat. Well, here's another thing you'll see, guys, that are growing. I forget, my wife said they're for something. You can't, yeah. They're not coconuts. Some other kind of whatever. And they cook them. What?
Can you watch the TV?
Yes, you make a watch TV. Yeah. Thank God for television. Anyhow, let's watch a little longer. Let me pause for a little bit till we get the meat on the griddle. Oh, they're putting, turn it right back on, they're putting the water on again. I'm not exactly sure. Victor is in the house screaming his head off. We're trying to wean him of being on the bed with us because he's able to climb up now and he's going to fall off the bed. And so we're trying to get him used to his crib. And he don't like it. Oh, I guess, oh, here we're digging a pit there, maybe? I think they're going to squeeze the poop out and bury it in the ground, maybe. That's... Oh, yeah. I smell it from here the second he tipped that thing over. Oh, boy.
I only saw poop being squeezed into the toilet bowl. That's enough of that. Get back to the pig. I'm gonna hear my son. He is screaming his head off in the house. Little adjustment here. By the way, if you're planning to do any blogging, get yourself a good tripod in the U.S. You cannot find a good one here. This one here that I'm using is a BELBON VE-3. BELBON. Bilbon? It belonged to my father. It's quite old, but it is built sturdy as shit. And that's what you don't see here, is that they don't look very sturdy. They're plastic or very thin aluminum. This one's aluminum, but even being aluminum, it's somewhat heavy because of the fact that it's built so sturdy. And I'm glad I had it to ship. I actually shipped two tripods, one a crappy one, and the crappy one is a small one I use, I carry around, because it's very small, and that's better than most of what I'm seeing here available to buy. No, we'll take the leg here. Now if you're coming into Manila or Cebu or something, you may have found better camera gear than you're finding down here if you're coming to Villageti. I'm not seeing a whole lot of good camera stuff. Even if it's the camera, the mount to hold the camera or the phone on a tripod, you can get through Amazon, and I'm sure there's probably tripods available through Amazon. Kind of hard when you're looking at stuff online to see how good it is. You don't necessarily see the quality of something. We got a big handful of guts. Lovely. Ooh, the poop from the smell of that poop is strong. The stench is strong with this one. I think they bought this pig from a local farmer, because a trike had showed up the other day. They had a trike parked over where the motorbikes are over there. And I hadn't seen that trike before. A Rusty chariot. And that's around the same time I saw the pig show up. So the pigs were just running around the yard. They'd have been in my yard if it wasn't for the fence. Not very much of a fence. Chickens can go right through it. Pigs could have gone under it if they realized they could. Nothing holding the bottom solid. Kind of sucks I can't let the dogs run loose, because they're small enough to walk right through. Okay, let me pause again for a little bit till we get a little more action again. They're just dismantling. Okay, everybody, I'm gonna go ahead and go inside. The flies are starting to get thick. I got a cut on my leg, they're driving me nuts. I had to tie a towel around it, because they will just relentlessly go after a cut. And there's already a big enough issue here with getting infections and cuts. You got a bunch of flies landing on you, you can deal with it. Good to carry some rags, simple rags, and tie it around your leg or your arm if that's where your cut is. And you don't just get and you can go to a pharmacy or buy a single Band-Aid. And you can get plenty of antibacterial here. So that's probably not a bad thing to ship if you got, if you're gonna ship, go hit pharmacy up for Band-Aids and antibacterial, because antibacterial is expensive here. And it's, you have to go to the pharmacist to get it. It's not on the shelf. You gotta go wait in line to get it. And a lot of times it's a little dinky tube about that long, and barely as big, not even as big around as my finger. And the bigger one might be about as big around as my finger, and about as long for the bigger one. I forget what that was cost, but I think it was like $10 for that. I don't remember. I think it was like $500 or $600 for the bigger one. So it's not cheap. I carry it on my kit all the time. I get a cut, I put it right away, put it on there. My wife instantly, oh no, put it on right away. And it's for real, dude. It's something you got to go after and make sure you take care of. They basically broke the whole thing down. They're still cutting it up a little bit. They're boiling some in the pot over here, but I think it's mostly like intestines and things. He's still cleaning out the last of the intestines over here. and they're breaking this down. I think they're going to be doing the cooking either inside or in a pot. Anyway, it's not going to be you know, roasting on a spit, although some of it might be on something. He was pointing at that pipe over there leaning against the house that they were going to cook it on a pit, but and they certainly got wood sitting here.
Waiting for the fire. Alright.
We're gonna kill a video here. It's already 30 minutes long. And welcome to the Philippines, everyone. Come on out. Join the party. I don't know if we're invited or not, but we'll probably get invited a little bit, at least get some food. They're very generous when it comes to party. Have a good one, everyone. Welcome to the Philippines.